Shannon, and I'm celebrating my 5-year cancer-free milestone this year with Celebrate Life. My story. Well, you know, us women, and I have to start it this way because it's funny, when we get home from work, we have to take our bras off and get all comfy. Well, I did that Monday, August 20th, 2018. Sorry. And I found a lump in my left breast. And I thought, that can't be right. So, but it was there. It was like the size of a Mancala marble, you know, that game you play. And I went to work the next day because I worked here at the time. And here being Cancer Treatment Centers of America, but now City of Hope. And I told my coworker, Kimberly, and she said that I needed to tell my boss. My boss was Dr. Spear, Chief of Staff. And I thought, okay, I will, but when I'm ready. Well, I didn't tell her, and she told her the next day. And once she told her, I didn't even have to do anything. I was scheduled for a biopsy, scans, you name it, I was scheduled. So I got my treatment plan probably about a week later. The biopsy obviously came back positive. And my treatment plan started with chemotherapy, September 14th, 2018. And I had 6 chemo treatments. I had additional antibody treatments. After that, 11 more treatments. I decided to have a double mastectomy because I wasn't keeping any of the tissue. I didn't want any more cancer or the possibility of it. So I had a double mastectomy in January of 2019. Excuse me. Had to recover from that and had radiation for 5 weeks, 5 days a week, 25 treatments. Reconstruction surgery September 13th, it was a Friday, of 2019. And I am now in just, you know, I come back for my 6 months, and hopefully after my next appointment should be on yearly appointments. So, yay! There's a lot that goes into figuring out your journey. Mine was, I had a lot of support, family support, friends here that stood beside me, behind me, caught me when I felt like I was gonna fall down. And my sister, who was at every single appointment that I had, no matter what the appointment was, she insisted on being there. My husband and my kids at home, and then extended family. I shared my story very publicly on Facebook so that I could keep all of the prayers going, because we are Christian people. We know that our prayers are heard, and they were. When I had my double mastectomy, it was after all of the chemo, and my breast oncologist, I guess, surgical oncologist, Dr. Pratty, came back and said, you have no evidence of disease. It was a very happy time. So that's my story in a nutshell. I would say to anybody being diagnosed, or going through treatment. To lean on the people close to you and let them help you. It's one thing I wanted to do. I wanted to do it myself. And there came a point in December of 2018, after my fifth chemo, where I had told a coworker that I would step in and help her, except for my chemo had got all mixed up and my blood count was too low, so I had to wait a couple days. I had to rest. I was told to go home and rest. I did. But then I was told to go home and take the rest of December off so that my body could recover. I would say listen to your body, truly listen to your body, because I was stubborn and really didn't want to, because I wanted to do it my way. But we have to listen and rest. So today, 5 years later, I celebrate by being here to celebrate birthdays with my grandkids, paddleboard with my sister, and enjoy life with my family, my husband, my mom, and friends. And I'm here to be able to do that. I don't know what would happen if I hadn't found the lump. Who knows? But now I'm going to get back to mountain biking, which I haven't done in a while. Another one of my favorite things to do. Paddleboarding with my sister. Celebrating my grandkids and my grown-up kids and my husband.